It is daylight right now. It is daylight and I have natural lighting for a video. Natural lighting, guys. It has been months since I had this and I have natural lighting. I've got to thank the earth for giving me this opportunity to give us daylight. I want to thank my parents because I have to thank my parents, of course. And I should thank God too. I mean, God is the reason for all of this existing. Without God, we wouldn't have any of this and this channel wouldn't exist. Thank you, God. Thank you. Kelly Lee Owens is a Welsh electronic producer who put out an album, the self-titled album, earlier in the year. An album I dismissed initially, thought it was kind of bland and uninspired. Well, as it's coming close to the end of the year, I wanted to go back to some of these albums that I didn't really think much about, didn't give a review, and just in case I've changed my opinion on them. And I'm glad I did, because I sure have changed my opinion on this album. I definitely was an absolute pleb thinking that this wasn't a good album when I first heard it. And I also want to say as well that, you know, gender isn't really a thing when it comes to music, but I really can't remember the last time I loved an electronic album from a female artist. Like, there are so few of them around that get that much attention, and I just feel like it's kind of crazy. I mean, I know there's Holly Herndon and Jenny Havel, who does feature on this album, but those artists I don't think have ever put out, like, an amazing album. But this Kelly Lee Owens one has really clicked with me. I think it's very ethereal. I think her vocals fit these tracks near perfectly at points. And there are some like outsider deep house, tech house tracks that feel John Hopkins inspired at points too, that I think work really well without any kind of vocals on them. But then there are some absolutely beautiful and haunting moments with her vocals, like on Keep Walking, where her voice is just kind of like sitting in the background. It's not quite up front in the mix. You can just hear it slightly. And I don't know, I just, when I hear it, I'm just like, like it just has such a nice sound to it. I do love the textured instrumentals across this album as well. We do get some really like intricate electronic sounds to the album, and I think like it's very unique for this year as well, because I do think a lot of electronic music has kind of fit into the same lane as of late, whereas this one plays it very subtly, very just ambient, but at the same time is very effective. Like, there are no electronic bangers on this album, so if that's the kind of stuff you're into, then maybe this album wouldn't be for you necessarily. But what this album does provide is some really beautiful and harrowing electronic music that just sits with me so well, because it's just created in such a detailed way. Not much else to say here. I do think the electronic genre is still a genre that I'm picking apart and learning how to decipher and review in an album review format. But what I hear is a lot of great music here, and I do think you should check it out if you haven't already. It's gonna creep onto my best of the year list, so I'm gonna give this a B+. Lyrically as well, at points, we're getting like this introvert personality coming from Kelly Lee Owens, how she's kind of like enclosed in herself, not really wanting to reach out to anyone or anyone in the world to just kind of like express herself. She feels very much inside and kind of like, you know, keeping herself to herself, really, and it really, really, really does fit her style so well. And I'm kind of excited to see where she goes in the future. I'm gonna include this on my best albums of the year list. Let me know what you think if you've heard it as well, and have a good day.